Geschichte never learns.
Die Partei ist Hitler!
Killing goes on and on and on, and humanity doesn't ever learn.
I was 15 years old, and we used to have a wonderful family life, and I really wanted to experience life. I wanted to have a boyfriend, I wanted to get married, I wanted to have a family, and so, you know, with 15, you don't want to die. I was really a very happy person before, and I really hoped this life can come back again. So I never, ever gave up hope. I had a good basis in life. You know, I had a happy childhood. And this is very important because I think that it was missing now a lot in families. You don't have anymore this family life. I was nearly on the point of giving up, I must admit that. But then my father appeared again, which was a miracle. And he said, you know, that soon the war will be finished and we'll make it, we'll be together again. And so he gave me courage again. And then luckily, I couldn't have survived much longer. But, you know, I never gave up like some people did. And there was Primo Levi, who was a scientist, an Italian who was, and he wrote many books, and he always said he knew when somebody was going to die, when they'd given up hope. And that was really the point. You, mentally, you must never give up hope that it will end and life will get better again. I thought this is already the worst that can happen, because I was not an intellectual, not like Anna, I didn't like reading. I was a very sporty child, and there I had to sit in, day out, not moving. That was really very, very tough for me. And then being afraid to be caught every night, are they going to come, are they going to find us? My mother had to struggle to keep me, sort of try to keep me happy, where she was as well very unhappy. So that was really very, very difficult, really. And, you know, I've lost faith in humanity. I had no hold on religion. But it was Otto Frank who came very often to our house. He was lost as well. And he came to a woman who needed help and a child who needed help. So he talked to us, and he was very philosophical. He sort of has accepted what had happened. And, you know, he was a very proud German, which always amazed us. You know, he said, I still love Germany, I'm a German. He was in the First World War, an officer. And he said, you know, if you look at history, every country had done terrible things. This was now Germany's turn to do something terrible. But not everybody is bad, you know, they were just cowardly, they didn't speak up. And so he tried to explain the situation to me. He tried to make life attractive to me, but I must say, I found it really very, very difficult. You know, I've accepted that this is what life is about. You have terrible things happening, but as well, I enjoy traveling, I love my family. I meet wonderful people. I've made many, many friends all over the world. Got a big correspondence, if I can manage it. The young people are really trying to change things, and I have hope for the future. I think life has a lot to offer. I'm really quite a happy person, though the past is something which is with me and it hurts. But I see as well some very, very wonderful things.